Welcome to the first of three videos on integration by parts. This video addresses the more basic examples involving integration by parts. The next two videos address some problems that are more involved. Let's go ahead and take a look at the formula for integration by parts. If we have an integral in the form of u dv, we can rewrite it as u times v minus the integral of v du. And the hopes is that this integral here will be easier to integrate than the starting integral. So we're going to take our starting integral, assign part of it equal to u, and the other part of it equal to dv. There are some guidelines for choosing u and dv. Normally we want to choose u so that du is simpler than u. And we will find du by finding the derivative of u times dx. Next, we want to choose dv to be something that's fairly easy to integrate. Once we do choose our dv, we will have to integrate to find v. Then we'll apply the formula, and hopefully, again, this integral here will be easier to integrate. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Here's our integration by parts formula. Here's our integral. So we have to choose a u. Let's let this part equal u, since du would be pretty straightforward, which leaves the remaining part, e to the x dx, as our dv. Let's take this information to the side. If our u is equal to x, then we know that du will equal the derivative of x, which is 1, times dx. dv is equal to e to the power of x dx, therefore, in order to find v, we'll have to integrate. Well, the integral of e to the x is just e to the x. So we have all the information we need to apply our integration by parts formula. The original integral is equal to u times v, which should be x e to the x, minus the integral of v times du. Well, v is e to the x, and du is just equal to dx. And this is a good outcome because we know the antiderivative of e to the x is just e to the x. Therefore, our antiderivative would just be x times e to the x minus e to the x plus c. Let's try another. Again, our first step is to determine which part will let equal u and which part equal dv. Now, one hint here is when the integrand involves natural log x, that is usually what our u is going to equal, which would leave x squared dx to be our dv. Again, we have to identify u and identify dv. Again, let's take this information over to the side. Our u is equal to natural log x, and our dv is equal to x squared dx. So in order to find du, we have to find the derivative of natural log x, which is 1 over x times dx. And when we integrate both sides of this equation, we're going to get v is equal to x cubed divided by 3. Okay, let's apply our integration by parts formula and see if this result will be easier to integrate. So we have u times v. The product of these two I'm going to rewrite as 1/3 x cubed natural log x minus the integral of v times du. Well, there's our v, and du is equal to 1 over x dx. Okay, we can clean this up. One factor of x will simplify out, and we can also factor out 1/3. So let's rewrite this as 1/3 times integral of x squared dx. And this is good news. We can easily integrate this. Add 1 to the exponent and divide by 3, plus c, clean this up one more time. And we have our final antiderivative. I think we have time for one more. Now this one might not be apparent to apply integration by parts because we only see one function, but if we wanted to, we could slide a 1 in here so we have 1 dx. So we'll let our natural log x equal our u and our 1 dx equal dv. Let's record that over here. Our u will be natural log x. Our dv will equal 1 dx. So we'll differentiate to find du. Be 1 over x dx. And to find v, we'll integrate both sides here. The antiderivative of 1 would give us x. Let's apply our formula. U times v would be x natural log x minus the integral of v times du. Our v is equal to x. Our du is equal to 1 over x dx. Again, this simplifies. X times 1 over x would just give us 1. And as we stated earlier, the antiderivative of 1 with respect to x would just be x. And then, of course, our plus c. I hope you found this video helpful as an introduction to integration by parts. As I mentioned earlier, the next two videos will do some problems that are a little more challenging.